Hi all, this is the badging video for the bench grinders here at MakeHaven. So in this video, we're gonna cover the four different bench grinders we have on this bench, just going around in a circle. So a bench grinder is really just a motor with spindles coming out either end of it, and then you can put various attachments on there. So this one is the wire wheel, and the purpose of the wire wheel is to remove paint or rust or scale other things from metal. And it is more open than the others, so you have better access to the wheel. The things to be conscious of from a safety perspective are you don't want to have something be pointed up into the wheel and get jammed down. You definitely don't want any fingers or anything getting stuck in there around the wheels. And then these little bristles will come flying out actually as you're using it. So it's extra important to be wearing eye protection when you're using this tool. The two wheels on here, this one is steel. So this is more abrasive and is good for harder materials. And then this one's brass. So if you're doing something softer and you don't want it to get totally scraped up, then you can use this. So here are two example pieces of material. Here's a piece of copper. So this is a softer metal and we'll use this on the brass wheel. And then this is a piece of steel. So we can see this on the steel wheel. So I'll get this spinning. And here's the piece of copper. So I'm gonna make sure it's not pointed up. We're gonna keep it angled down. And then you can see here, it's nice and shiny where we hit it with a wire wheel to remove that sort of oxide tarnished layer on the surface. And then on the steel, there's a similar effect, you know, cleaning that off. It's important to make sure the upper edges here don't catch into the wheel or else they'll get thrown right down. All right. You want to make sure to have a firm grip on your material whenever you are using this, because it can get thrown out of your hands if you aren't holding on to it nice and firmly. And then obviously when you're done, just make sure to clean up any mess. So now we'll move on to the next one. This is kind of the most traditional bench grinder. This is what people often mean when they say bench grinder. So a few notes in terms of safety, you similarly want to make sure that the pieces are always angled down, you're holding them firmly. This is gonna throw lots of sparks, so be aware of that. This is only for ferrous metals. So no aluminum, no bronze, brass, things like that. Those metals will just melt and gum up the wheel and then potentially cause it to explode. So here we have two different grits. This one's a finer grit, this one's a heavier grit just for removing more material. Over time, the wheels will start to lose their shape, you know, as they get ground down. And so then we can use a diamond dressing stone to get them back to square and clean out any gunk if someone did mistakenly use aluminum on it. So like here you can see those little specks look like someone mistakenly put aluminum on here, or maybe brass, hard to tell. So we'll have to clean that out. Same with this tool as the wire wheel. You want to make sure that you don't have any sleeves or anything that could get caught up in here, because that'll pull you in really fast. So make sure none of that. This also has a spark guard, so you can put this down to help deflect sparks from your face if the sparks are shooting upwards. Also, this can just, you know, you can work through the shield, look through it, which is just an extra safety measure. So I'll spin this up and then grind that piece of steel on here so you can see what it looks like. So first we're gonna do the heavier grit on this side. And I'm standing out of the way of the wheels. Generally, it's best if you can help it to not stand right in front, because if this wheel were to explode, then it's coming at you, and now it's not. And then similarly, you wanna make sure you have a nice firm grip on your material. And I often use my finger, my thumb here, to make sure I have a good control of the piece as we feed it into the wheel. And then the finer wheel. If you are grinding something smaller and you can't safely hold it in your hands without putting your fingers at risk of getting hit by the wheel or, you know, accidentally dropping the piece down in that crack, you can grab vice grips, which are these, to hold on to the piece more safely. So those will clamp onto your part, and then you can safely hold on to it while you're grinding it. So now we're gonna go over to the next wheel, and this bench grinder has CBN wheels on it. So CBN stands for cubic boron nitride, which is a synthetic compound that is almost as hard as diamonds. So traditionally these would be diamond wheels, but we use CBN instead because it has better thermal properties than diamond does. And the reason that's useful is because the primary use of this is for grinding carbide, but it can also do hardened steel. And if you tried to grind hardened steel on a diamond wheel, then it heats up and can degrade the diamond, but the CBN can handle that better. So this is specifically for hard steels, whether that's hardened steel or a carbide. Here we have a lathe tool, and here you can see that this is the tool, and brazed onto that tip is a carbide piece. And often you'll want to shape that piece of carbide to a particular shape to be useful for whatever you're turning on the lathe. And that is what this is for. So the two wheels, this is 180 grit and this is 80 grit. So this is more rough and will remove more material more quickly. Then this will leave a finer finish and remove material less quickly. And I labeled the sides there so you can see which is which. So this insert looks pretty good, but we're just gonna sharpen up the tip of it just so it has a nice crisp tip up there. And then we'll be good to go. So it has a little light in the back so we can have good visibility on our work. And I'm just gonna use the fine wheel because we're just removing a little bit of material here. Something else to note is that these bases are adjustable, so you can slide them forwards and backwards and then adjust the position and the angle of this tool rest so that you get it just where you want it, you know, depending on whatever angle you're trying to achieve on your piece. And it's important to really crank down on these knobs so that they don't move on you. The way these little knobs work is to adjust the position, you can pull them out and turn them and then tighten. So like this one, let's say it was hitting this, then we can pull it out so we have more clearance to tighten. So now you can see that there's a nice crisp tip on that piece of carbide, which will help us, you know, get a nice finish on our piece when we're churning it. And when you're done using this guy, just make sure to turn that light off so that it doesn't burn out on us. And now we will go over to the polishing wheel. So the polishing wheel is just another bench grinder with these wheels out on the ends. They're cotton wheels. There's all different kinds. These have stitches in them, which you can see going up the side that kind of keeps it a little stiffer. There are two different grits that we've applied to each of them. So this one has a gray on it and this a green. And those are called rouges or polishing compounds. And they are used to polish your work. So, you know, once it's already pretty smooth, then you want it to get it shiny. Then first you can use the green compound, that's sort of a medium grit, and it'll help, you know, get it pretty shiny. And then using the gray can get it to a mirror finish where you could actually see your face in it, or, you know, see some kind of reflection in it. The cover is because we don't want metal filings from the other tools getting on the wheels. If they do, then those will just scratch the things that you're trying to polish, which would defeat the purpose. So that's why this cover's on here, to keep the wheels clean. We'll take it off for now. So here we can see the box with our two polishing compounds in here. To load up the wheels with the compound, you just turn it on. and then take the compound. And you don't need much, but you just go like that. And that just loads up the wheel. It takes some of it and rubs off in there. And now when you're polishing, it will use that as like super fine sandpaper to sand your pieces and make them nice and smooth. The reason that the whole wheels are exposed is because sometimes you want to get into all kinds of nooks and crannies around your piece. And so this just helps make it easier. It also means that there's nothing for it to grab into. You mostly don't need a tool rest for when you're polishing. You can just kind of freehand it. It's not gonna really grab super hard. That said, you do wanna make sure your pieces are angled down. If it's angled up, it will still grab and throw it downwards, which you don't want. And then same as all the others, you just wanna sweep and vacuum up from this tool because it'll leave some stuff around as it is spinning. And unlike the CBN wheels and the bench grinder, with this, you can polish any material you want on it. Make sure the material is pretty clean so that you aren't getting like dust of that into the wheel, which will then contaminate future things. But aside from that, you can polish, you know, most metals on here. So those are the various bench grinders we have here on the bench here at MakeHaven. So I hope you found that useful, and thanks for watching.